This has been a video idea on my mind for months, everyone. Merms versus pigs. Obviously, I was unable to produce such a thing, because we've been incapable of befriending Merms since the beginning. Until now. So today, we pit pork against fish in tests that will compare their combat prowess, resource management, and even their overall availability. So let's get to it. And of course, the first question that should be answered is what their exact availability actually looks like. And I have no doubt that pig houses will come to dominate the numbers game in most worlds, especially when concentrated at the Pig King. And seeing as how they can spawn in more biomes over that of Merm Huts to begin with, it appears as if we have a clear winner already, right? Wrong. You notice how I said pig houses and not pigs themselves? Yeah. Here's the thing. It really doesn't matter how many houses you get generated, as each house only equals a single porky pig. And if that pig dies, you'll be waiting 4 days for another one. Can we alleviate things via our own construction? Certainly, and we'll discuss this later. But what about Merms? How do they fare at their baseline availability? Make no mistake, spawning constraints will play a massive role in these debates from world to world, because yes, we really can just focus on one biome and one biome alone for our little green men here. There are worlds that will certainly have rundown houses every which way to Sunday, while others where it seems there ain't a Merm in sight. But the thing that we should really put focus on is how Merm houses truly operate themselves. For you see, for every one Merm house, 4 total Merms reside in it. That is 4 times that of pig houses. Yes, they share identical respawn times. However, Merms have something else over that of our porky companions. They all come out at night. Well, mostly dusk, but you know what I mean. The little piggies cry all the way home, while the Merms are just getting started. But we have a couple more things to weigh in here before we get to the far easier to quantify aspects of this comparison. Building more houses for each kind, and our characters' abilities to get each on their side. Let's keep things simple. Every character can craft pig houses most everywhere, while Wirt is alone in her ability to create more Merm huts and can only do so within the marsh or, of course, her tiles. So kind of score one for the piggies there, right? But don't lose sight of the use of the celestial portal here now. We always have the option to switch between characters to take full advantage of most everything discussed here and beyond. Both types of homes are relatively easy to build. However, keep in mind that without a pig farm of sorts, pig butts may actually limit your construction here, especially if we're trying to not hammer huts. Normal pigs only have a 25% chance to drop a butt, so you'll need to forcibly turn each you see into a werepig to certainly up those odds there. And really, the only other good sources out there would be pig heads, and those are non-renewable. Listen, getting more butts and therefore houses is simple, but perhaps not as simple or as quickly available as you may think when you truly think about it. Now compare that to building crafts Merm houses to find very similar wood usage, however far less resource refinement. No tons of rocks for cut stone, and no third resource that is difficult to amass or limited in any way, really. Reeds are and will always be abundant, so there is no worries there. And if we're talking about getting fish, then note that Merms always drop one upon death, and that every frickin' pond in the overworld holds at least 10 of the suckers. Sure, crass Merm houses only hold a single Merm, but so do pig houses. Sure, Wirt is the only one who can craft them, but no one is stopping you from using the celestial portal when needed. But now, the real question. Who can befriend who? And this is so dang simple, you might not even believe it, and it might hurt to hear it. Everyone can befriend Merms, while all but Weber, Wartox, and now Wirt can befriend Pigmen. But if this is the case, Merms win this category easily in my book. Yes, you'll need at least one Wirt at some point in order to craft the easily craftable clever disguise for our other survivors. But that's not a limit. What also isn't a limit is how bloody easy it is to befriend Merms over that of pigs. Pigs require meat or eggs, both of which are high commodities for many out there, while merms can be befriended through simple seeds. I mean, it's like no contest considering how the actual loyalties of both work the same way anyways. But how do both parties perform their duties while under your command? Well, when it comes to combat, you should already know what to expect, really. Sure, pigmen do more damage at 33 per hit over a merm's 30, but we must factor in speed and overall health of our followers here. Also keep in mind that we really aren't going after anything super big or super bad, because super big bads against either of these teams are gonna win with ease. Tree Guardians, however, are the middle ground, at a nice chunk of health and 150 damage per hit to mobs. Pigs can and will take but 2 hits to the noggin before death, while merms can withstand 4 hits from our sentient tree men here. And that is a far bigger deal than you may believe. Let's throw in merms' faster speed in with it all, and suddenly we have times where merms aren't even getting hit, while our pigs are dying left and frickin' right. In short, it is no contest, especially when we up it a notch and toss in the newly introduced warrior merms. Heck, even without a merm king's blessing, the warriors will wipe the floor with even their regular merm counterparts, but upgrade them and they'll boast over 600 health total and 50 damage a hit. Incredible. And oh yeah, note that other survivors can absolutely manage all of this and do not need to wear the clever disguise once the merms are loyal to you, so bonus points there. And I just threw this in for a fun little quick bit. As some of you may know, pigmen can free you from the Yukus's Miyukus attack, which can actually go a heck of a long way in making a solo encounter with the beast very easy. But sadly, it appears that our new merm friends cannot or will not do the same. So they'll just leave you to your own devices. Score one for the pigs though in the background. But now, resource gathering. Not gonna try to sell it otherwise. For most survivors, pigs will be the choice for early game wood chopping. But if you can manage to befriend merms early, you should absolutely go for it. Merms hit trees faster. They become far less distracted than pigs do. Seemingly spread themselves out better, although that's situational. But they also require far less intervention from the player throughout the process. It's something I never really bothered with, because we simply never had a comparison. But oh boy, do you need to re-engage pigmen, not only more often than merms, but also through more activity. Every merm will jump into action the moment you initiate it yourself, while sometimes pigs just stand around doing nothing for a time even while you're doing stuff. Without question, merms win. To further build on this, merms can mine. And pigs will do bugger all in that regard. And the cherry on top, merms will work during the day, come dusk, and even night. Pigs, well, will be pigs. And it just keeps getting better, everyone. With the introduction of craftable merm houses, we can now populate the caves with them. You can plant the houses, craft the fortifications for them warriors, build the royalty kits, and yes, even have yourself yet another king down below to gain all the benefits that come with that. Beautiful. And man, pigs have really fallen behind now, huh? Well, in most areas, yes. But when it comes to the kings, there is but one who reigns. For you see, the only downside of the pig king currently is the fact that Wurt simply can't trade with him. And this is Wurt alone, mind you. As for the merm king, every survivor can trade with the fat fish himself just as long as you have the disguise on. But his loot is really uneventful beyond tentacle spots for the most part. The pig king, on the other hand, is one of, if not the most lucrative source of gold in all of Don't Starve history. So long may the fat man reign. But there you have it, everyone. A mighty comparison between two of the constant's now most versatile mobs. You might still be asking about who's actually won at the end of the day, but honestly, that whole question is subjective. Clearly, one trumps the other in many tests. But man, it's really really hard to beat pigmen loot and farms at times. And clearly, a group is a better option for most scenarios. However, to some, one might not be available for a time. All this video was a showcase to show just what some new mechanics could mean for your experience with certain mobs. And I do hope that it opened your mind a little bit. But thanks for watching, folks. Well wishes to all, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye!